Hey everyone, Leo with the Dreaming Tree, and welcome to the assembly video for our Sundae gift card holder. Many of you have been asking for birthday cards for younger people. Now obviously this one in the bundle will work for pretty much anybody, but especially for younger kids. So here we go. We've got everything cut out, and I've sort of kind of pre-assembled it, but not really, just kind of stacked it. This is the main structure, very simple. The idea here is that we're gonna glue this section together. You can put your little gift card in there and then you fold it up and it fits in an envelope. It's wonderful. Okay, so this is the main structure. You're gonna fold at this score line here as well as here. And then we have these little flaps here that we're gonna use to keep this in place. So we could technically just do that now. So let's get our glue going onto these little tabs here. And I'm gonna go a little bit generous with the glue on this so that I can spread it out to the very edge. Okay, and then literally we're just gonna take this and fold it up and just make sure that you give it a few moments to set. I've got ink all over my fingers because I was pre-inking everything off camera. You don't need to watch me do that, okay? So there it is. And then I also, since this folds up, this section here and this little section where the spoon goes are the two areas where if you are going to ink, that's the sections you want to ink. Everything else is going to be covered up. Okay, so since I did this on white, I used a nice turquoise. You can probably use a blue as well, and that would be fine. Now for the front of the card, we have this little piece here and this little accent piece. So let's get some glue going on this little accent. And I'm gonna go easy with the glue here because I've got some little holes on these little scallops and I don't want that glue to pop through. So just go easy. And you just wanna line this up flush with the top as well as the sides, like so. And I'm just kinda using my finger to feel that it's flush with the top and just press that down like so. Okay, and then what we're gonna do is we're just gonna glue this right to the top. This section here is gonna be flush with the top here, but we also wanna make sure that it's centered so that we have a little bit of this area showing on both the left and right side, as well as the bottom, okay? So what we can do is we're gonna put glue on the back of this piece. Now we don't need to go all the way out because you can see that a little bit of it is sticking off. So just bring it in maybe about a quarter of an inch. Okay, so let's get that glued in place. It's a very simple little gift card holder, card, whatever you want to call it. And I'm going to just about there. I think that will work. Again, flush with the top and then do your best to get it centered as well so that we have an even border on the left and right. And it's kind of cool because it may seem like there's a lot of negative space here, but we actually have a little bow on a band that's going to hold this thing shut. So it's pretty snazzy. Okay, so there we have it. And it's gonna open up. You can see that it pretty much fits any standard size gift card. You could also put some money in here if you want. It's totally up to you. Okay, all right, now we can start putting together the main part of it here. This is the base, okay? And we're gonna put this piece on first. This is a print to cut element. If you're using a Cricut, what you're going to do is bring this in and just flatten it and then do a print to cut. Now I did kind of ink only because I didn't pre-assemble this. I kind of inked everything, which I just come to find out is not really necessary because this layer is going to go on top. If anything, if you're going to ink this section here and you're cutting it out of a brown, I would go with a little bit of a darker brown. Okay, and you really only need to ink the stem and the spoon. Okay, so let's flip this over and let's get this glued down. Got a little bit of surface area here, so you gotta try to move quickly, but definitely don't miss any of the areas, especially out on the perimeter and the little areas that are dangling. The, I guess it would be the topping on the ice cream, a little chocolate, I think would be. Okay, so there we go. And this is kind of a little loose there at the top. It's kind of flimsy, so be careful as you apply this to just Just ensure that you get everything lined up correctly. There we go, just like that. Press that down into place. Now, before we put on the major layers that go on top here, we do want to put this little piece in place. It kind of fits in like a little puzzle. You can see exactly where it goes. It goes right there. Okay, so let's flip this over. And I'm going to go very sparse with the glue here. It's a pretty small little piece. So go easy if you need to, or if you feel that you need to, just kind of hit it with your finger. Spread that glue out, thin it out a bit. Okay, and just pop that in, like I said, just like a little puzzle piece. Wonderful. Okay, so now that we have that in place, we're going to take this large piece here, and this is going to go on next, like so. Okay, so let's flip this over and apply our glue. Like so. There we go. And just make sure that you get good coverage on this. And this is not flimsy, but there's a lot of little detailed areas, so you just want to make sure that you do get it lined up as accurately as possible. Just kind of let it hover above the area where we're placing it, and just make sure it looks good before you commit and press that down into place. I had a little bit of glue right there. Just rub that off before it dries. Everything is looking really good so far. Okay, wonderful. Next, well, at this point we can pretty much work on whichever section we want. So I'm going to actually put the what is that? I guess it's like a red topping that goes on the, I guess that's the chocolate ice cream. Okay, so get that on there, and that's going to go right here on the middle scoop. Match that up as accurately as you can. There we go, just like that. Wonderful. Okay, and next we have, well, you can actually take, you can take and glue this little spoon down. This is going to go on like a little puzzle piece as well. So let's flip that over. And I'm just using a little series of dots. There's not really that much room up there to move it around. There we go, just like that. And match it up with the little holes there at the top. There we go. Wonderful. And next, we can put our, this is our whipped cream. And that's going to go right there. You can kind of see this little, that little wave, I guess you can call it. Just want to match that up along with the rest of it. So I think we could probably get this card done in under 20 minutes, not including cutting, obviously, but the cutting goes pretty quick too, since there's really not that much to cut. Okay, there we go. Pop that into place. As you can see, I inked that with some turquoise as well. It's typically the go-to color when we're dealing with a white. Now this piece is going to go right here, so you can see this little scallop here, this little half circle. That's going to match up there, and then over here, it's kind of like, almost looks like a little heart on the right-hand side that's going to match up with this section here. And it is kind of important to do some inking on this so that we can see some separation between these two layers. Otherwise, it's just going to look very flat. Okay, so make sure you hit this with some ink. If you're not familiar with inking, I have a little blog post on our website that highlights a few videos where I show some various techniques. Okay, next, we're going to take the little cherry and pop the cherry on top, of course. And that goes right there. Make sure you match it up with the little cutout. And there you have it. And then finally, we have this little piece here. It's going to go right there. And this is identical to the other piece that looks just like it. So it doesn't matter which one you use. They're literally the same exact cutout. Okay, but this one we can actually, well, I guess we put glue on the entire other piece too, so that's fine. There we go, just like that. Make sure it kind of butts up to where the ice cream starts. And I had it a little bit off to the right, so I'm going to fix that. And there we go. Okay, so now we can open this up, and as you can see, It's gonna go right on here like so, matching it up with the, what's it called? The shadow layer behind it. So we will need to apply glue to the entire surface on the back here. And again, we've got quite a bit of surface area here, so just do some circles and try to get as much covered as possible before it dries. And I'm kind of looking at the stem of the cherry for my initial alignment, then I'm panning over to the ice cream over here. And then finally, looks like it all matches up nicely. Wonderful. Okay, great. So the main part of the card is done. Look how cool that is. Open it up, there you go. And of course, you've got some room on the back to write something. You can also do, if you're familiar with how to, you can have your machine actually write whatever sentiment you want to write. Okay, so let's put together our little band and the bow. So the band is like this. You'll notice that it's kind of double scored here, just to make it a little bit thicker, as well as here. Okay, it's going to go together like this. I've got one little tab here. And now this is glitter, so when you're gluing glitter, if you're doing it, if you're using glitter like I am, you might need to give it a few extra moments to fully set. So line that up, and you can actually take it and put it down flat, because I think that will actually help it. So once you get it lined up, put it down flat and then just kind of press it down with your finger and hold it. Give it a few moments to set, and you may even want to take this, and I'm just going to take the very edge of this and just kind of tuck it. Where is it? Can you see? It's at the six here. Just going to tuck it under the mat. Let the mat do the work while we assemble our bow. Okay. Now the bow does have some score marks in the center. Just ignore those. You do want to fold the score marks on the sides like so. And I'm going to take a dowel and place the dowel, or place the one of the loops here. This is one loop, that's another loop. Place the loops between your finger and the dowel. Take it, bring it up about 45 degrees, or 90 degrees, I should say, and run it through. Okay, same thing over here, about 90 degrees, and run it through, and you can see what it did. It made it somewhat round. Okay, so next what we're gonna do is take and apply some glue to this little rectangle here. You'll notice that there's some score lines there, so keep it within the confines of that little rectangle and bring that rectangle in to the rectangle in the center and press that down and hold it in place until it fully sets. Now, the inside of this glitter is actually more of a paper sort of medium, so this shouldn't take as long to set, but here, I'm going to take and put glue on the other rectangle and bring it down, and that's going to go onto some glitter. So that may take a few extra moments to set if you're doing it the way I'm doing it. Just be aware that glitter does take a little bit longer to grab and hold. Okay. So we'll take that. I've got the glue on the rectangle, and I'm putting it right on top of the other rectangular section. Okay, now some of you, I've seen you do this. You have some clothes hangers, or what are they called? Clothespins. You just kind of put them on there. You could probably even use like a chip clip, like a potato chip clip or something, just to hold it down if you don't want to sit here and wait for it to completely dry. It's not that big of a deal, and I think it's already kind of taking hold. But either way, we also have this little piece here, and what we're going to do with this piece, and I don't want to rush this because I can tell that it's still pulling away because it hasn't fully dried. I'm taking this piece out now to take a look at it and make sure that that is fully set, and it is. So that looks great. Now what I would do after you put this band together, obviously there's a, oh, you know what, it actually probably doesn't even matter. I would, this is the side where the tab is. I'd probably use this as the front, so the side opposite of that. Okay, and let's see here. Yeah, I'm still not completely happy with that. I'm gonna let that sit for a second. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is we're gonna take this piece, we're gonna put it over the center so that it's centered on the center of the bow, and then you can take it and just fold it back and fold the other side back as well so that they meet on the other side here. I guess, you know, hot glue may be the way to go with this. Let me see if my hot glue gun actually has any juice. I have a wireless one. are cordless. Let me see if I can pop it on. Okay, well, yeah, actually, this one's pretty cool. You can find this on our supply list, on our app. Actually, it's by Westcott. We have a link to it on Amazon, or to Amazon. And it's pretty snazzy because it doesn't have, you know, there's no cord. I always hated the cord. Not a big fan. So anyway, we have that little strip in the center. You can see it there. I'm going to fold one end down and apply a little bit of glue just right there on top of it. And I might need to put another glue stick in there, but I think it's okay. And then we're going to push that down right on top of the other one to close it up. And that just makes it look nice and dimensional on the front. You can obviously see that there's another layer of paper on there, which I think is cool. Okay, so now that that's done, we're going to take and, glad I have the hot glue gun, you can literally just take it and glue it right to the center of the band. Do your best to get it nice and centered. If you're unsure, you can always use your mat. And what I'm doing is just kind of centering it between the inch marks here. And then this little blue line here is your center. So you can literally just use that as your center point. Whoops. I'll leave that there. That looks pretty good. Okay, there we go. And what is going on here? That thing just moved on its own. I think there's a ghost in here. That's probably just one of those little wispies from the hot glue. So we'll just throw a little bit of hot glue on the back of our bow, preferably on the side where we put hot glue on that little rectangular section. And then just pop that right in the center. Use that little center line. I'm using on my mat, I have a nice blue line right there that I can use to help me gauge whether or not it's centered. And I think that looks pretty good. Okay, so now we have that done. This guy here literally just holds the card closed so it doesn't open up, and it adds a nice little finishing touch to it. Okay, so there you have it. So that's it for this one. Now, of course, technically it's not exactly a card, but it is. But anytime we release a card, we always include an envelope, a nice coordinating envelope. I already have it pre-folded, so we're going to take these two flaps and bring them in, and then this one's going to go up like so. But we do need to add a little bit of glue along the inside here, all the way down, and here, all the way down, and then take this flap, flip it up, press down, and just hold that in place for a few moments while it sets. Okay, now if you are putting this in an envelope, know that this bow is going to flatten out a little bit, and that's okay. It'll snap back a little bit. Okay, and we also have this little piece here that's going to give our flap a nice two-tone look. So what we want to do with that, okay, so this little piece here, what we're going to do is we're going to put glue on this entire section here. Let me double check that real quick. I believe that, yep, that's what we're going to do. So we're going to apply glue to this entire section here, all the way down to the fold, but don't go beyond the fold. Okay, try to get that glue out to the very edge of the flap as well. And then let's throw a little bit on the cherry as well as the stem. Okay, and a little tip for this, take this piece and pop it down on the surface, push it up against the fold where the score mark is, and just make sure it's nice and centered, and then take this, bring it down, and press. There we go. Just like that. And just hold that in place for a moment while it sets. There we go. And then finally, we have a little overlay for the cherry. My first one, I think, is AC. What color is this? This is Cascade, I think. It's Cascade. It's too dark to be AC Pool. Okay, so we'll throw a little bit of glue on the cherry and just match that up with the shadow layer. Okay, that's mostly just for the stem and to add some dimension. And then we'll take the red part here, throw a little bit of glue on that, and pop it in place. Put the finishing touch on there, the cherry on top, as they say. There we go. Okay. So there's our beautiful coordinating envelope. We have our gift card slash gift card, I'm sorry, our card slash gift card holder. As you can see, it fits in there nicely. Don't be afraid to smush it down. If you do plan on mailing this, I would bring it directly to the clerk at the front desk at the post office, have them hand cancel it, and that will do it. So as you can see, you pull that down, it opens up, happy birthday. Of course, you've got this whole back section to write your sentiment and a little place for a gift card or some money. Bada bing, bada boom, all good. By the way, I'll also gonna add some little gold pearls in this little area here, just to jazz it up a little bit more, and I think that's gonna do it. So anyway, very quick, very simple, fun, colorful, exciting, perfect little way to give a gift card or some money for that special person in your life. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please take a moment, visit our YouTube channel, which now has 47,000 subscribers plus and growing daily. Hit that subscribe button, also ring that bell, so that you get notifications anytime we release a new product, whether it be paid or free. You'll also be notified if we go live, which we've been doing more and more of. And if you make this or anything from our new bundle, I'd love to see it, and so would the rest of our community. So head over to your Facebook and do a search for Dreaming Tree Group. Or if you want, you can type in this little URL that you see here at the bottom of your screen. So happy birthday to whoever it is you're making this for. And as always, I look forward to crafting with you again. Hey, thanks for crafting along with me. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, check out some of our other videos, and also please consider hitting that subscribe button. And don't forget to visit our site and check out our free SVG section, where we have over 140 free SVG files complete with assembly videos. I look forward to crafting with you soon.